thing is so simple, it's almost instructional. This is key, you must be easy.
That is the mother of the house.
Here comes the first follower with a crucial role. He publicly shows everyone else how to follow. Notice how the leader embraces him as an equal. So it's not about the leader anymore, it's about them, plural. Notice how he's calling to his friends to join in.
Since your mother called you the children.
Stand out, you brave ridicule yourself. Being a first follower is an underappreciated form of leadership. The first follower transforms a lone nut into a leader. If the leader is the flint, the first follower is the spark that really makes the fire. Now here's the second follower.
That's your firstborn.
It's proof the first has done well. Now it's not a lone nut, and it's not two nuts. Three is a crowd, and a crowd is news. A movement must be public. Make sure outsiders see more than just the leader. Everyone needs to see the followers, because new followers emulate followers, not the leader. Now here come two more people, then three more immediately. Now we've got momentum. This is the tipping point, and now we have a movement.
Now you have all your children.
When people jump in, it's no longer risky. If they were on the fence before, there's no reason not to join in now. They won't stand out, they won't be ridiculed, and they will be part of the in crowd if they hurry. And over the next minute, you see the rest who prefer to stay part of the crowd, because eventually they'd be ridiculed for not joining. And ladies and gentlemen, that is how a movement is made. So let's recap what we've learned. If you are a version of the shirtless dancing guy, all alone, remember the importance of nurturing your first few followers as equals, making everything clearly about the movement, not you. Be public, be easy to follow. But the biggest lesson here, did you catch it? Leadership is over-glorified. Yes, it started with the shirtless guy, and he'll get all the credit, but you saw what really happened. It was the first follower that transformed a lone nut into a leader. There's no movement without the first follower. See, we're told that we all need to be leaders, but that would be really ineffective. The best way to make a movement, if you really care, is to courageously follow and show others how to follow. When you find a lone nut doing something great, have the guts to be the first person to stand up and join in.
Okay, brilliant. I think it's one of the most profound videos ever made. The first follower turns the lone nut into a leader. Is that okay? So mommy, now you know what your role is. You're gonna turn hubby into a leader. Okay, but let's take this video game with no sound. Just play it. And then I will show you something here. We have three people here, and three is always the answer. The first one we call the initiator. That is, in this case, the first dancer. So, we will come back to that. The second one is the validator. And that is why we say validation from the mother is so important. The third one is the peer impactor, and that is the firstborn. So the guy with the black shirt, okay? So when you've asked people now who actually brought the crowd, then some say this one, some say this and so on. But actually the real answer is all three. So if you want really heaven at home, focus on all three. Your firstborn has a phenomenal role to play in this process. Never neglect that. It's very, very, very important. But first, before the firstborn can follow you, you got to dance together. And that's why my wife said it so beautifully, a united front, a united front. So where does it all start? You can play the video. You can play the video in the background. It's okay. They can listen and watch. No sound. It all starts with this first dancer. Got to take the sound down completely. Okay, and this is this. It all depends, what does the first dancer dance? So, is the first dancer's life like this? If you ask children, what is your dad's life all about? Then they will tell you what the first dancer dances. So if your whole life is making money, 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 they know it. They know it. And do the women like it? They like the dress, but I'm not sure they like the dance. Therefore, many millennials say, I wish you can keep your money, just give me love. I will exchange money for love. What does the first dancer dance? And therefore, that's why I talk with men and say, so what is the most important in your life? What is the center of your life? And outside the center of your life, at the training, we train the fathers to have this family crest where they know these are the four most important things for the family. And that is the music that you dance. You dance your values. You dance those priority things in life. For us, it was empowering people, spiritual growth, exposure and impact broadly in this world. And the last one was excellence, to think different than other people, uniqueness that we wanted to transfer. So I danced that in my life. I demonstrated that. I lived that. That was the things that I lived. Because of this, it was so easy for my wife to dance with me. Many, many a day, my wife would say to me, Cassie, if you were out just to make money, you would not get that support from me that you're getting now. But because I know you do something super significant in life, I'll give you all my support. And I don't care if you are away from home so much. More 120 nights per year, I will tolerate that. Because I know it is something significant and that I can show the children how I dance with you. And I honor my wife for one thing. On all those 120 nights per year, since they grew up from 3 years old to 28 years old, since they grew up in those years, my wife never, never disgraced me, never gave any hint of daddy is away because he's not caring about us. No. Daddy is away because we are a family that must impact the world. This is how daddy is doing it while you're doing it at school. And I'm doing it at home or in the township as I'm helping the other people. That valuing, you cannot be a validator if you're not valuing what your husband is doing. You understand what I'm saying? And that's why husband and wife must sit together and say, so what are the important things for us? So when I do it, that you value me and therefore validate me and therefore we become one, a strong unit. Strong unit then determines a home culture. And when you have that culture, the first child comes into the world, sees this culture, convergence on the important things, and start to do the same thing. And this one then brings the other children to follow and becomes the peer impactor. And therefore, you impact not only your life, but many, many other people's lives by the movement spiraling out from your household. I think that is the most important thing. So that's why I don't understand the word balanced. Because when people say, how can I have a balanced life? What does that mean? I don't understand what it means. Ask someone that wants to win the Olympic medal at the Olympic Games, do you have a balanced life? What do they say? I have a focused life. You understand? I like this much better. I'm not interested in a balanced life. I have a focused life. So if you then say to me, but what about your physical situation? What about exercising? I say, for the sake of the center, I exercise. That's why I'm fit. That's why I can take on any 60-year-old on a few exercises, okay? Maybe a number of you, 30 years old, also on push-ups, I can take on, I think most of you, not all of you. But for one reason only, and that is so that the center can have the attention. And I train for the sake of the center, you understand? A focused life, focused life. All my relationships. When I speak to you, my friend, we can talk a little bit about sport and politics and stuff like this, but it won't take long. And then I will get you that we talk about the focus that I have in life. Because I want lives to be meaningful. Because I believe God created everyone, every single person on planet Earth to represent Him. And I want you to understand this. Because that is a fulfilling sense of I have a purpose in life. I mean something. There is some significance in my life. And because of that, all the children do the same. Everyone does the same, and it's heaven at home. So maybe we should start with that, and then leave it for other practical questions, and then we see if we have still time to pan it out with other things. I'd rather just elaborate with practical questions if you have that.
Okay, let's all thank Reverend Cassie Carsons and his wife. Thank you very, very much for the very, very, very good information that he has shared with us. Now, the most important part of the program. I'm sure everybody has a question of their own. I can bring the mic to you, or you, if you don't want to speak to over the mic, you can put your questions down on a paper and hand it to me. So who will be the brave first? The first one to be brave and ask the first question. Show of hands. Anyone?
I'm going to ask
See?
I'm going to ask for the table. There's many families in the Philippines. We have parents who work out of the country for all the visitors, or we also have single parents. So what do we do with those kind of families if there's just one parent who's available in the household?
Okay, we will answer each in a different way. We believe that we need leaders, is that right? Initiators. We believe also that a man in the house is the leader, but not a positional, not above. Like you saw in the video, no one is above anyone else, you understand? That just means initiative, takers, and that men should be there. And that the women can be just as strong or even stronger with their validation and support. So we want to not accept that the future of the Philippines will be the same. Is that okay? Are you with me on that? We don't follow culture, we make culture. Are you with me on that? So we change the future. Are you with me on that? So in 20 years from now, the men and the women will not work abroad. Are you with me on that?